This is Scott McGarry. He's a scientist at our energy center in Newcastle. Scott's part of our advanced energy storage team, and they've just developed a backpack that's got the potential to revolutionise wearable technology. But let's hold up a second. What do we mean by wearable tech? Wearable technologies are electronic devices that are integrated into clothing or accessories. They can be things like Google Glass, the Apple Watch, or the Gadget Hat. Here at CSIRO, we're working with a range of technologies in this area, like tracking systems, virtual reality, camouflage, and electronics. Which takes us back to Scott and his backpack. The ElectroFIED, or Flexible Integrated Energy Device Backpack, incorporates an energy harvester that actually generates its own electricity as a person moves. It has three main components. The energy harvesting system that gathers energy, Wait a minute, that's not Scott. Let's try again. It has three main components. The energy harvesting system that gathers energy, a flexible battery that stores energy, and fabric woven from conductive fibres which can double as cabling to connect to electronic devices. So how does it create electricity? It's all to do with movement. The roller in the backpack strap turns as the backpack bounces up and down. Inside the roller is a small DC generator that produces the electricity. The electricity then flows through the USB port built into the side to conductive fabrics that are seamlessly integrated into the bag. No more need for chunky wires and cables. The energy generated can be fed directly to an electronic device or back to the flexible battery stored in the backpack.
And are those rips part of it, or is that just a fashion thing?
I'm not qualified to comment on that.
This experimental rig produces a peak power of around 3 watts of electricity. That's enough to power 2 small LED lights, as demonstrated by Scott. But once it progresses beyond a prototype, it will be able to power smartphones, laptops, GPS systems, or any other device. Not that there's anything wrong with Scott's LED lights.